To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles, and by opposing them to die to sleep no more, and by a sleep to say we end the heartache and the thousand natural shocks that flesh's hair do. 'Tis a consummation devoutly to be wished, to die to sleep perchance to dream. Aye, that's the rub, for in that sleep of death what dreams may come. When we have shuffled of this mortal coil, must give us pause. There's a respect that makes calamity of so long life. For who would bear the whips and scorns of time? Thou oppresses wrong the proud man's contumely, the pangs of despised love, the lost delay, the insolence of office and the spurns that patient merit of unworthy takes, when he himself might his quietus make with a bare bodkin. Who would Fidelis bear to grunt and sweat under a weary life, but that the dread of something after death, the uncovered county from whose bourne no traveler returned, puzzles the will and makes us rather bear those ills we have than to fly that we know of? Thus conscience does make us cowards of a soul, and thus native hue of resolution is sickle o'er the pale crest of thought, and enterprises of great pitch and monument with disregard their currents turn awry and lose the name of action.